Welcome to the next session of radiology in diagnosis of tuberculosis. So, in this session, we are going to discuss about the role of radiology in the diagnosis of pulmonary tuberculosis. Radiological features of pulmonary TB is conventionally divided into primary pulmonary tuberculosis and post primary pulmonary TB, each with distinct radiological patterns with considerable overlap. The radiological features depends on age of the patient, underlying immune status and prior exposure. Primary TB commonly affects children and adolescents, now increasingly encountered in adult also. Generally, primary TB is a self-limiting, it is not symptomatic. Classically, six entities have been described in primary tuberculosis. The first two condition, one is a primary complex and ganglio pulmonary TB, is characteristic of a primary TB. Rest of the consolidation, pleural effusion, miliary tuberculosis and tracheobronchial stenosis have been shared by both primary and post primary tuberculosis. Primary focus or gone focus is an area of consolidation or caseating granuloma that most commonly occur in lower part of the upper lobe or upper part of the lower lobe. With good immunity, gone foci usually heals by calcification. In chest X-ray, the foci may seen as a calcification. This is only a telltale evidence of the past TB disease. Lymphangitis, it is a discrete linear opacity with erased contour and miliary nodules in string of pearls aligned along the lymphatic vessel. It represents tuberculous inflammation of the lymphatics linking a gone foci to hilar lymph node. Next is a gone complex. When the tubercle bacilli disseminate from gone foci via lymphatics, it reaches regional hilar node. So, the node become infected and they enlarge. The enlarged node is known as a gone complex. So, the rich primary foci and gone foci constitute a primary complex. In 95% of the patient, the primary foci and gone complex heal either by fibrosis or calcification. It is called as a Ranke foci or Ranke complex. Next is a ganglio pulmonary TB. It is characterized by enlargement of the mediastinal hilar lymph node with associated parenchymal abnormality. This differentiate primary TB from post pulmonary tuberculosis. It is seen in 96% of the children and 46% of the adult patient. So, the commonly involved nodes are right paratracheal, hilar, subcarinal, iotopulmonary, and the most common site in Indian population, right paratracheal is the most common. So, bilateral adenopathy is seen in 3% of the cases. So, this is a lymph node, it is a right paratracheal seen in a primary TB. Next is a consolidation. So, in 5% of the patient, the gone foci extend into the other parts of the lung. usually in a immunocompromised patient. Consolidation may involve a lobule, segment or lobar. The primary consolidation usually involves the anterior segment of the upper lobe, middle lobe or lower lobe, usually may be associated with the lymphadenopathy. That is a more important to differentiate consolidation from the post primary. So, this is a consolidation associated with the lymph node. Next is a pleural effusion. Pleural effusion is one of the most common form of a extrapulmonary TB, and it is more common in a primary disease. It accounts for 38% cases of a primary TB and usually common in adults than children. It occurs 3 to 6 months after primary infection. So, it manifests as a unilateral large effusion, and without loculation. That is very, very important. So, usually with treatment it resolves completely without any complication. Pleural effusion in a primary TB may be associated with a lymph node, and sometimes they may have a parenchymal involvement. This is a miliary TB. Miliary is more common in a primary and is seen in 2.6% of the primary TB. It results from the heterogeneous dissemination of the discrete TB bacilli, leading to development of innumerable small granules in lung or other organ. Radiologically, miliary TB is looks like a small similar discrete nodules and sparing the apex, mostly involving the base. So, here there is also a lymph node involvement also. So, this is a more important point. Miliary tuberculosis in a primary may be associated with the lymph node enlargement. So, here this is a patient with a miliary TB with a pleural involvement also. Next is a atelectasis. It is frequently present in primary tuberculosis due to airway compression by adjacent lymphadenopathy or airway stenosis. The atelectasis is most notable in the right upper lobe anterior segment. We call it as a epituberculosis, and it is also seen in a middle lobe. So, it is popularly known as a Brock syndrome. This X-ray shows a middle lobe collapse. Here there is a silhouette of the right cardiac border. The lateral X-ray showing classically a wedged middle lobe collapse. It is usually seen in a primary pulmonary tuberculosis. Coming to the post primary TB, post primary TB occurs in previously sensitized patients and results either from reinfection or reactivation of a dormant bacilli in primary infection. Primary, post primary occurs predominantly in adolescent and adults. Lymph node involvement never ever occur in a post primary TB. The most commonest finding is a consolidation. It appears as a poor, ill defined area of opacity, usually with the predilection of a upper lobe, apical segment and posterior segment. From the apex to lunar, there is a, it spreads by bronchogenic spread and reaches the lower lobe also. Here there is a extension of the lesion from upper lobe to lower lobe. So, here it is a nodular lesion. So, usually it is a, early it is a fluffy opacity and they coalesce, they form a nodular opacity. There may be a non-segmental. This is a consolidation involving the lobe, upper lobe. This is also consolidation involving upper lobe. Usually airspace opacity usually ill-defined. It becomes sharper when it touches the fissure. So, it is a upper lobe consolidation. Next is a cavity. TB cavity is the sine qua non of a post primary TB and is evident in 40% of the cases. It usually occurs in an area of consolidation. The walls may be thin or smooth or thick and nodular. So, there may be presence of air fluid level in 10% of the cavity. Presence of air fluid level indicates super infection with a fungus or a secondary infection. This is also a multiple cavity. So, miliary tuberculosis, it can also occur in a post primary also. It is, however, it is a less common in a post primary. It is again caused by erosion of the bronchial artery into systemic artery or a pulmonary vein. If this is a miliary nodules, they usually appear as a 2 to 3 millimeter millet seed nodules. They are small, similar, discrete. Usually they seen prominent in the lower zone. So, here there is no lymphadenopathy. This is very important. It differentiates the miliary tuberculosis from the primary. Miliary tuberculosis in primary TB, they have associated lymphadenopathy. If miliary TB is untreated, they coalesce, they form a present as a con, they become confluent and present as a snowstorm appearance, mimicking a ARDS. So, if appropriate treatment is started, the miliary nodules, they completely resolve without any calcification. Next is a pulmonary tuberculoma. So, pulmonary tuberculoma radiologically appear as a well circumscribed nodule or mass. They appear either single or multiple. The size varies from 0.5 to 4 centimeter. Pathologically, it is a caseous mass encapsulated by a multiple concentric layer of connective tissue without surrounding inflammation and spread. So, this is a tuberculoma. So, the patient is this X-ray showing even pleural thickening also. So, here there is a tuberculoma. The natural course of tuberculoma without ATT is classified into progression, stationary or regression. Stationary course is seen in 30 to 50% of the cases. Again, pleural effusion, it is also seen in a post primary. Here it is definitely due to rupture of the subpleural foci or cavity into the pleural space. Here the pleural effusion is either small or sometimes loculated, because presence of pleural effusion in a post primary, we should suspect it is a definitely empyema. So, it leads to a poor prognosis. So, we have to treat adequately with anti-TB in a case of pleural effusion of a post primary. If left untreated, they form pleural thickening and calcification. Next is a pneumothorax. Pneumothorax is nothing but air in the pleural space. So, this is a collapsed lung margin. So, it is a right left pneumothorax. Here is a right pneumothorax. Here it is a, the mediastinum is completely shifted to left side. It is known as a tension pneumothorax. It occurs approximately in 5% of the patients with a post primary tuberculosis. See, this pneumothorax is usually seen in severe cavitary tuberculosis, but rarely seen in a miliary tuberculosis. The pathogenesis of pneumothorax is a caseous necrosis of the subpleural foci and they rupture into the pleural space. This is a hydropneumothorax, that is a presence of both air and fluid. It is usually seen in a post primary. This is a loculated hydropneumothorax, that is it is very difficult to differentiate from the lung abscess. So with this we conclude the radiological features of a primary pulmonary TB and post primary pulmonary TB. Thank you.